Ooh. Oh. Welcome back to Let's Play Stasis Blind. We have bed lockers. Didn't realize that. Okay. So, yeah. Beginning episode now. Maybe there's something in here we can find to be of use. The locker is open but empty. Says something about containing memories. Some of the beds here sport a small safe, which is obviously used for personal effects and valuables. Locker is open but empty. Is there more of these bed lockers? One on the other side. So, there's no bed locker here on these. Oh man, I wanted it to be something I could do something with. Personal locker. No, that's this. I swear, we need some, you know, highlighting selectables is really needed here. Open but empty. So I wonder if maybe the other beds in the other room might have some of these lockers. Otherwise, I'm back to square one. Just not knowing what the hell to do. Sleeping cot. I see something else for a second. No, wait, oh, he's walking. I didn't mean to click that. I thought I saw something else between the PDA and the sleeping cot. No. So these... Oh god. Is that the cat? Or a person? Okay. Oh man, I thought I was onto something. I don't want to bore you guys, so I'll be back when I discover anything new. Oh my god, guys. I didn't even realize it, but I actually picked up something from that other locker without even realizing it. It's a linen bed sheet. So I'm assuming we're going to use that to climb down. I didn't even notice that. All I thought was that, yeah, it said it was empty, just like the other one. Hey, hey. Finally, we get somewhere.
Okay, now let's see what I can do.
Let's indeed.
Easy goes.
Oh shit! Oh shit!
Priceless, ew. Okay, you gotta come up out of that. You can't just drown here. How deep is it?
Damn it! How the hell am I gonna get back up?
Got John. You're gonna get yourself killed.
Huh?
Hey, this is all new.
Yeah. Access drain. An unfamiliar smell emanates from the corroded drain. Yeah, unfamiliar because we don't normally hang out in sewers. Sludge. This passage of sludge reflects the maze of slats above, creating a queasy illusion of infinitude. That's quite a word, infinitude. The hollow tubes snake cylindrically in their cavities. That's quite a vocabulary here. The path of these ducts form a wave that runs along the top of this unnavigable thicket of tubes. A dense web of pipes obscures the view after just a few feet. Alright, so we can go both ways. I guess pick a way, huh? Yeah, you can't go very fast. I double-clicked it to make him go faster. Hello. Oh my. Drainage pipe. A massive open drainage pipe rings the center of the room, just barely protruding above the flood of sludge. In the poor light, only the serpentine outlines of the piping can be seen. The large access pipe emits a helpful light. Oh, this we can get up there. Yeah, ladder. A ladder leads from the lip of the tunnel down to the floor of the sludgy chamber. That's our way out, or a way to somewhere else, anyway. A gas tank full of methane sits ensconced in the complex housing berth. Cautionary text runs down the side of its pipes in small print. Oh, well, I wonder if we could shut off the methane here, then, the gas. Is that what gas is? Methane gas? I think it's a poisonous gas, right? Release valves line the catwalk in a steady row, each one corroded. Of course, I've noticed these. Corpse of Andre Sen, science officer. Personal data tag, security level 2. And Steward Manichuk, security level 0. A diagram of the pump station spans a large portion of the room. Printed matter doesn't have a tendency to lose power. True. A gas tank full of methane. Cautionary text along the pipes warn of a full tank of methane gas. More pipes. Release valves line the catwalk in a steady row, each one corroded. I think I read that one already. Alright. Can I look at the pipe? Where is he going? He won't walk to it. Alright. Well, how do I get up here? Or I don't. I can't advance past this. On the catwalk. I do my moves on the catwalk with dead bodies. Alright, I could go up or I could go back the other way. Sorry guys, maybe I should have just gone up there. It takes me so long to run. Kinda didn't realize that. I'll have to try to run anyway. Maybe it's not so deep this way? Access drain. You gets confused when I try to have him look at this stuff. Alright, let's go. Yummy! Oh, we must be under the entertainment section. Where are we? Oh, okay. There's a John! Overhead access pipe. This throughway passes over the channel below, providing access between the two terminus points. The sides are scoured with a variety of markings. Really? Ooh. At first glance, the half-submerged skeleton seems to lurk in wake. In wait, like a prehistoric predator. John Kernast, classified, Kane Corporation. Personal data tag, stuff 7907, blood 0, O negative, security level classified. Ooh. That one comes up with a little Kane Corporation icon, too. Fallen grating, a lump of metal has fallen from this jungle of alleys. Bendon Brown, classified, Kane Corporation. Blood O positive, security level classified. Another one. Remy Andre Borgen, classified, Kane Corporation. How many we got? Borgen, Brown. This unknown one. Kernast. Looks like there's another one here, but maybe it's this. Maybe it's from this? I don't know. It looks like just those. Okay, so I can go up with the fallen grating. Is he still moving? Okay. He stopped making noise also when he went under there. Okay, the pathing is messed up down here in the sewer.
The skin looks dissolved.
Your plug suit should protect you from any harmful chemicals. For a short while, at least.
Yeah, not enough to protect us from the other thing. The other, chemicals. So he's still going back that way. He's still going back that way, okay. I don't know how to get up here. So let's... Fallen grating looks like a way out. Oh, hello. I'm always trying to find out where we are in this scene. Okay, so we've got the holographic dancer of some kind. Holographic emitter. The seductive dancer sways her hips to a silent tune. Oh no, I can hear the tune. Sergei Koptev, operations officer. Personal data tag 4273 GNS, whatever that means. Blood B negative. Security level 3. Oh wow.
See, these people were just killed. I've been skinned.
Yeah, we saw them on the monitors.
No.
The cameras.
I went hunting with my uncle when I was a kid. I know what skinning looks like. I did it myself, but.
I'm a vegetarian.
Well, good for you. I guess you don't want to eat these things, which is good. Bucket of Mud. The name of the club glares in radiant neon, whose ultraviolet light dances around the room. The bodies clutch one another in a strangely intimate embrace. Dead bones. Stephen Cameron, computer systems specialist. Blood A positive, security level 3. Edward Sheldrick, propulsion specialist. Blood AB positive, security level 3. Sergey, yeah, we look at Sergey. Paul Cook, junior engineer. David Leggetti, environmental systems specialist. He has security level 3. The metal floor grating has been twisted and rent as if by incredibly powerful hands or machinery. The hands stand just as skeletal as the other remains in the room. Look at one. There is some good flavor text here. Visa Tavanen, electrical engineer. He's only have security level 3. Trees. Paul Cook, Lachetti. These table platforms weren't designed for the kind of spectacle on view right now. No kidding. Edward Sheldrick, I guess we looked at him. These are unknowns. Michael Manuel Angelo DeVries, tactical officer. You know what I'm wondering? I'm thinking these might be the names of the Kickstarter people who donated to the Kickstarter fund. Tactical officer, security level 2. PDA here. Pile of dead bodies. The skeletal remains lie clustered together around the room as if they died in a stampede or clutching each other. Somehow the bones hold no scraps of flesh. Yeah, something's been eating. A pool cue rests atop the game table, the tip chalked up and ready for use. Apparently we can take that. Two bodies lie splayed on this pool table. They might have tried to escape what killed the others here. Justin Lotus, mission specialist, security level 3. Yeah, right? They might be photographs uploaded by people who have, you know, pledged a certain amount. Upload your name and might be their actual blood type. I don't know. Who knows, right? Through the transparent surface of the pool table, you can see how the metal grating bends toward the massive rupture in the center of the room. Tom Van Nierigenen, Assistant Intelligence Officer, Kane Corporation. Security level classified. Of course, it might also be the development team. Cigarette vending machine. This room must have been zoned for smoking, as a cigarette vending machine sits idle here. Television screens. Countless video screens with nothing to say. Alright. Apparently we can get a cigarette as well. There's a cigarette on top, we don't want that. Alright, let's get the pull cue then. It's chalked up and ready to use. Maybe I can use it to mess with the machine or knock the cigarette off the top. Oh, I just broke it. Okay. Kane Corporation lighter. Made of metal. So we can't get descriptions for things in here. Okay. I've got a lighter. Burn the bodies! Burn them all. That's another way down. Oh, this is where it came up from, duh. For some reason, I thought it was this side of the room or something. Apparently we can also take this, but let me check out this PDA here. Run like your life depends on it. Neville Chambers. January 4th. Can't believe I'm actually in space! Space! I'm in space! I know that a whole lot of people have been here, but you really don't appreciate the cosmos until you see it from beyond Earth's atmosphere. It's not something to be taken for granted. I hope this is the beginning of a long journey for me. If I could just live in the void for eternity, I would give anything. You'd be really bored after a while, wouldn't you? June 24th. That was quite a while back. January, right? And then June. I don't miss Earth at all. Unbelievably, the gazes of passing asteroids are less cold than most humans. It's amazing to see all of the constellations up close and personal. I've started writing a comic about myself, the space adventurer. Although I've just been sweeping and dusting on the Groomlake, I know it's my key to becoming one with the cosmos. Really. September 11th. My comic book is coming along nicely. I've decided that I'm not going to make myself a superhero, but I'll lead a team of super geniuses and will use the power of the universe to save it. My sidekick is Carl Sagan. Einstein pilots the Bridge Pond, that's my awesome ship, and Hawking crushes stuff with his cybernetic limbs. Issue 1 done. What about Neil deGrasse Tyson? Play the game HoloQ. Free game coupon. I want it. December 26th. Well, it's supposed to be the end, yeah. Despite what I've been through, I still love space. I've seen enough movies to know how this is going to end for me. I wish my comic books hadn't been lost in the Tremors. They're pretty much my final testament. I even finished issue 6. We destroy a race of parasitic squid-like guys, except we keep one as a pet and train it to fight for us. It also bites Einstein, who gets a cool scar as a result. Anyway, it's too late for that. I'm going to spend my final days taking in the universe to any chamber I can find. Peace out, universe. Taking in the universe. Okay, so we're going to watch the universe, or he's going to break through the freaking window and let the universe take him? Door to main annex. Door leads back to the main annex. So we can look at the holographic projector, but not the hologram itself. See if he reacts to any of this stuff. We can get over to that one. No. Where are you going? Alright, I guess we're taking the emitter. Let me just look over here.
Looks like a recent addition.
Can't take it? It's stuck? How about we drill it free?
This is a useful drill.
Oh, nice. Yeah, I've used this for like 4 different things already. We keep running out of everything else, but the drill always remains. Holographic emitter, that's cool. Wonder what you can use that for. I mean, to trick the monster, right? Monsters. I guess we still can't go through that door. We gotta go back the way we came. Oh! I didn't see this PDA. So bright and sparkly in here as it is. Anything else? I don't want to miss anything. I see that PDA. I guess it's just this one. Stacy Dipinar. I actually like the music. It sounds familiar. November 3rd. Tanmi and I had a great evening together. This mystery alcohol is pretty much a miracle. It made my throat burn terribly, though. Ha. November 23rd. Oh. My. God. I thought I was literally going to starve. This stupid fungus crap ruined all the food. We finally got a delivery and it was great to eat something. The new food isn't as good as the food Hydro makes, though. Hydro, huh? November 27th. I wonder if Kane Corp would let me volunteer for Project Seed. Surely they give some great benefits for volunteering. You just have to have been pregnant before, I think. Do abortions disqualify you? I'll look into it. Guess she's had one. November 30th. Nope, they need volunteers who have actually birthed a baby or miscarried late in the pregnancy. You also have to be at least 18 years old, for whatever reason. How'd Kane know it was 17 anyway? How sad, only 17. I thought those documents looked darn realistic. Oh well, I guess they didn't want a bunch of experiments on me anyway. December 19th. I'm literally freaking out. The Groomlake went like boom, and then stuff started falling and shaking. I almost got a fork stuck in my neck. Jeb got caught under a bed. Now I feel bad for calling him a creepy old man all the time. December 20th. I had a good idea. I said that we should use the tubes that we send the experiments through to get people to medical because the trams are broken. Everyone loves me now. Tammy is going to help. She's so brave sometimes. I'd go too, but she said not to. She's kind of like a mom to me, but she said that would be weird because we're best friends. December 26th. Tammy's not back yet. I don't know what to do. If I never had that stupid idea, she'd be okay. It's my fault. Robin says it's not my fault, but I know it is. I'm just so stupid and useless, like I was at home. I don't even have a home. All I do is hurt people. Jeez. That didn't turn out well. She was so happy before. This is a late entry. December 28th. I wanted him to get me. I killed Tammy, and now it's my turn. What? She killed Tammy? Zane carried me to the recreation area. I kicked and screamed as loud as I could, but he dragged me in anyway. I wish I could be a good person like him. Oh, she didn't literally kill Tammy. She thinks she ended up resulting in Tammy's death. I wish I could be a good person like him. I'm useless. I think I'll sit by the door so that they get me first. Maybe I can buy everyone else a second or two. It's sad. It's horrible. Oh, the humanity. Alright. I guess we're done in here. We got a bunch of new stuff, though. Exciting. I think we need a lighter for anything? You want to burn the trees down?
It doesn't work like that.
Well, yeah, it's wood, isn't it? Burn the bodies? Burn the pile of dead
That's
bodies.
That's just crazy. Although... No. Crazy.
Alright. Not sure we can do with the pool cue. Maybe with the pool cue we can reach those valves, right? Down in the sewer? Alright. So this apparently is a dead end, so we have to go back to where we were. Just double checking. Yeah, pool cue. Hologram thing and lighter. At least here we don't have to tie anything on. We could just slide down that whatever it is. Grating. Yeah, it's a fallen grating. Alright. Fun in the sewers. Bring the family. Really love this game. I'm surprised. I knew I'd like it. You know, I don't choose games that I think I won't like, but I'm really, really enjoying it. The flavor text and everything's really interesting to look at and explore, and that's what my favorite thing about games is, just exploring. And figuring out puzzles and stuff is good too, but... And I do like dialogue, but this really doesn't have dialogue that you can choose. Alright, so we have... Before I go up the ladder... Let me see if I can mess with... these valves here. Well, they're all corroded. Pump station diagram. So where are we? Diagram of the pump station. Oh, there's... 1, 2, 3, 4. Is that a valve there, too? See, he has more than that.
I don't know what I was thinking there. I don't know what I was thinking there.
Say in a different way.
I can try to make it fit, but it may break.
So how does anyone else get up there? Let's go up for now anyway. Let's get this crap off of us. Hanging lanterns. Strung along the passage hang pairs of lights like baleful eyes. Indeed. What was that? What? I keep catching a glimpse of something. Another lantern? Oh, that, what's his name's cat?
Goddamn cat.
Stray cat. A mangy feline purrs uncaringly at its present predicament. Oh, no, it's not purring. It is making unhappy meow sounds and hissing. Oh, God. That's your idea of... I can get the cat?
Here, kitty, 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 kitty.
I couldn't run.
Come here, come here.
I need something with which to entice the cat. Maybe a piece off a corpse down below?
I won't hurt you.
Cat is not happy. Oh, crap.
I can't believe that just happened.
Oh, God. It sounds like something laughing. You know I want to try something, don't you? I can't go up to it. Alright. It's just wall there. Alright, so... Poor cat! Oh boy. Blood. PDA. This is back where we were. Oh, this is the crossway. Zane Adams. Is it a different cat? Talking about a cat here. May 19th. Every single day, Grant brings his poor little cat to the plant. Oh, it's Grant's cat. I swear to God, it's going to die of methane inhalation. I guess that's the cat. Became a stray cat. June 4th. I did a number of my ankle. Doc says I'll need to keep any weight off of it for a few days. I hope Grant can pick up the slack for me. October 31st. Some of these idiots think that the fungus spreading through the Groomlake was caused by aliens. The place is disgusting, so of course it's going to be overrun with mold. December 25th. If you guys try to get the tram station B repaired, I wanted to go and help, but I don't know shit about trams or stations. Anyway, they haven't come back yet, so everyone's more than a little worried. So I'm sure next is the last entry. Yep. December 28th. The guys in Sleeping Bock B are absolutely bleeped. I'm reasonably sure that we're next. Stacy almost didn't make it in. Poor girl's too young for this. That's a funny thought. Who is old enough for this? Who reaches a point in their life where they figure they're ready to be ripped apart by God knows what? Oh, he's the one that threw Stacy in the entertainment section, I think? Is that Stacy, her name? I don't want to bother running through it all just to see her name. I'm so bad with names. Alright. I think it was Stacy because they said she was young. Lovely.